state line. Welcome to the Deep South, rookie. We've got wetlands, the blues, and the American story, not to mention some of the best hunting you'll find anywhere on this earth. But the floods this year have been worse than ever, and our community is at its breaking point. Camp Haven, the summer camp we worked so hard to open last year, is under threat. If there's one thing I've learned living here, it's that Mississippi Acres folk are resilient. We don't need a savior, just a little extra help. And that's where you come in. Looks like the end of the road. I'm so sorry, but I've actually got to run. I've got a pile of papers I need to grade. I'll call you as soon as I've got a signal. Promise. There, finally. I had to add actual cell service to the list of things I miss about Chicago. Sorry that I'm so short on Southern hospitality right now, but we've got a bit of a situation. Steve Ernie from our flood relief committee was out delivering supplies to elders who couldn't evacuate on time. The levee overtopped and his trunk got totally submerged. Everything scattered. He got away safe, but we don't have the funds to let anything go to waste. Can you go take a look? The water should have mostly receded by now. I'll mark the location on your hunter mate. Thank you. you're almost there. You starting to get goosebumps, or is it just me? The Delta's a weird place. He said he got stuck somewhere over there by those cypress knees. Bingo. Those are the supplies. Got everything? Thanks. This is doing us a huge favor. Hey, are the shadows playing tricks, or is that a briefcase I'm seeing on my feed? Let me make a quick call. Hey, Mrs. Tackett. My new counselor's out where Steve dropped the flood supplies, and there's a briefcase hanging from a tree branch. You know if that's... Uh-huh. Yes, ma'am. Give me just a sec. She wants to talk to you.
Well, Miss Davis has got you out on a fine excursion this time of night. Betty Tackett here, chairwoman of the Mississippi Delta Big Game Club. I hate to ask, Sugar, but can you grab the briefcase? Steve's a little ornery and he'll pitch a fit if he don't get his papers back.
You'll have to... Well, nothing to it. Wow. Hear that, Mrs. Tackett? You are phenomenal. What happened to that rookie kid I got my hunting license with who couldn't hit a broadside shot on a stationary target?
Loud and clear. I'm gonna extend you an invite if you keep that up. I'm down for the count since I broke my neck, but Steve will get you an application. Hell, he owes you.
You tracking gators, rookie? Want some advice? Let's take that later, why don't we? We gotta let you go, Mrs. Tackett. Hey, I don't want no silent treatment. You've read Camp Haven's handbook, right?
All the best now. Don't be a stranger, y'all.
Rule number one, our differences are our strengths. There's no shame in trying something new. Betty's lovely, but she's as southern as all get out, as they say in these parts. With everything that entails. I'll give you a few pointers. You show me what you can do. It's win-win. Any markings on that briefcase? Not that I don't believe it's Steve's, it's just... First, find where they gather. Following the waterway is a good bet. I don't see anything suspicious. Let's get those supplies to the people who need them. Just make sure you're packing appropriately. Their skulls are thicker than a Mississippi senator's. There's an outpost not far from here. Can you swing by and drop the briefcase and supplies off there? Maybe get your breath back, too. Check the Codex field guide if you need help. This codex has a full listing of Emmy's patented tips and tricks for how to survive the Mississippi Delta, free of charge. Just, don't read the back. You know, most Delta folks aren't especially well off. Never take this for granted, is what I'm trying to say. Fresh meat. Alligators are ambush predators. They'll lie motionless for hours under the water, waiting for the right moment to strike. So wait them out, watch the water, and strike when you see them come up. We didn't hunt gators much but for self-defense when I spent my summers here. My daddy taught me not to aim between the eyes. That'll just have it pitching a fit. Try to land a shot between the eye and the ear instead. That destroys the brain, kills it quickly. I know you've got work to do, but when you're stalking out here, it's best to take it slow, like a long, hot, lazy Delta summer. Yeah, I know. Crawling around in the mud is gross. It's also the best way to get close to your prey. So make like the gators and get down on all fours. See the depression on the ground? Looks like they've been basking around here. Try sneaking up on them when they're idle. We didn't hunt gators much but for self-defense when I spent my summers here. My daddy taught me not to aim between the eyes. That'll just have it pitching a fit. Try to land a shot between the eye and the ear instead. That destroys the brain, kills it quickly. Hunting's all about planning, right? And planning starts with glassing. Get to know what's out there, you'll have a much easier time.